The book's name, original name, is Women Who Blow on Nuts. But in French, it is the title changed to What Good is a Revolution If I Cannot Dance to It? And I cannot say it in French, I'm sorry. It takes place in Arab land, so to speak. It starts from Tunisia, goes through Libya, Egypt, Mediterranean, and then Lebanon, and then to the Syrian border. It's about four women going on a journey, a very interesting journey, one of them being Madame Lila, who is an elderly, spectacular lady. The other three are younger women. They hit the road for several different reasons, but around the half of the book, you understand that Madame Lila has a, you know, secret plan. Women Who Blow on Nuts is a verse from Quran, the Islamic holy book. In old times, women were doing witchcraft by tying the knots and then praying on these knots. And then at the end of the praying, they were blowing their breath on these knots. That's why the Quran said, be aware of those women who blow on knots. So I took this verse from the Quran and I, you know, changed the verse a little bit in a way. And I made up a story out of this because I thought if Quran thinks that there is a certain magic in women's breath, that means that women can use this magic in their breath in other parts of the life as well. And I do believe that women create magic in life by blowing their breath into things, into men, into children, into, you know, whatever job they're doing and so on and so forth. So this book is about actually the magic in women's breath. Women Who Blow on Nuts have four characters, four main characters, but a lot of, you know, side characters as well, because these women ran into various different people on the road who are more or less actors of Arab Spring, which the story is taking place. Amira is a Tunisian dancer and a journalist. And there is Mariam, who is a historian, Egyptian, and Madame Lila, the spectacular old lady. And there is the narrator, and it's a bit tricky thing because it sounds like me, and I always tell the whole story as if it is me, but that's a bit tricky subject that I would like readers to find out. They don't necessarily represent Tunisian women or Egyptian women or the Arab woman, whatever that is, and I don't know if there is such a thing. But I think they're telling a lot about what Arab women are not. It is, I think, the depth of their characters tell that all these, you know, stereotypes are incredibly ridiculous. I do think that cultural differences are overrated. At the end of the day, we watch the same television series and we read the same books, we read the same newspapers and so on and so forth. Even when we are joking, we have the same references. So overall, the book, in one of the aspects of the book is making fun of those stereotypes. There's a scene in Libya where women militias are watching Sex and the City eating pizza, so imagine the rest. The importance of fiction is different for a person who's coming from Western countries, I think. Whereas I come from a, you know, part of the world where reality is far more crazy than the fiction. I write all my novels on the very thin line between real and fiction. And whenever there's a crazy story, you can be sure that it's the real stuff. Whereas there is more convincing, you know, aspect of the book, it is definitely fiction. And when you come from that part of the world where fiction cannot keep up with the craziness of the reality, it is not easy to bend the reality towards fiction. But the power of fiction comes, I think, from preserving the beauty within that craziness. I do think that words are not strong enough or resilient enough to save the world or like save the humanity. Whereas I do think that words have a duty to preserve beauty, take the beauty out of the craziness, insanity of humanity, and put it somewhere where they can be preserved for coming generations, which I think is very important.